We're in Styria, tucked away in the mountains of central Austria. It looks like just another quiet spot on the map, but behind these doors, something pretty unusual is happening. This is a small business that's essentially turned itself into a private energy factory. And the funny thing is, its owner Daniel never actually planned for any of this to happen.
We are in 8770 St. Michael, which is quite in the center of Styria. In some areas we have loads of snows, which brings the poles to fall. And if that happens, there are areas they have no electricity for 3 days or 4 days.
Now you have to remember, this building wasn't built for solar arrays or massive battery banks. It used to be a local grocery store that sat empty and unused for 20 years. Daniel's original plan was simple, just use the space for storage. But then things started to connect. A joinery workshop here, a financial office there, and eventually an Italian restaurant up the hill. It all started being pulled together by one growing idea. The real turning point wasn't actually about business, it was about family. Daniel started worrying about security, but instead of a noisy, rattling generator that wouldn't be practical, he went looking for something silent. Something reliable, that could keep his family safe even if the grid went dark. And that search, that's what led him to Victron Energy. You may not be aware, this, as well as a number of other recent films, are available in different languages. Just click the cog icon and change the audio track.
Why it came to all the things is because of my son. I always wanted to have a secure place for him, and then was COVID started. And I said, okay, we need something in case of a blackout, in case of whatever can happen. We need a place where we can go to and we are safe. Okay, let's make a solar system. But there are not many on the markets. They had the requirements I had. So I wanted to have a blackout system, which is totally an island if needed. This is how I came to Victron. So all the researches I made, it was Victron is the best on the market. So we bought it and we started with an east-west system and with 3 multiples 5,000, and this was the start.
He unboxed this first inverter and was pretty much hooked immediately. It wasn't just that it worked, it was the fact that he could actually build on it. It wasn't a closed loop, it was a starting point.
I was curious how it will be. Then it was quite interesting to unpack it. And then when we installed it, we said, oh, we are amazed. It's great how this system works and how easy it is. No question about it. You need to have loads of brain work done first. But once it's installed, it's running easy and perfect. You know, more is always better, and better having than needed. And we started next with a different inverter. We integrated it into the system. This was something important for us, that we can also show people then, you have a perfect Victron system, but you can use any inverter to connect it to it. So you have the master and the slave. That's why we have the south side is integrated with the, now it's a Fronius, so because Fronius is working closer together with Victron, it's better to integration. And that was the next level, next step. And then we said, okay, we need more. So that's why we said, okay, let's do three more. So we have 6 multiples there, we have 120 kilowatts of battery storage. We started with 4 batteries, so 20 kilowatts.
This is the moment where a simple business backup system starts evolving into a full-blown power plant. Of course, Daniel isn't doing this entirely alone. He's backed by a team of installers and engineers who know exactly how far you can push this hardware. And together, they really did push it.
We originally started with 15 kilowatts of inverter power right here. We have expanded, and on the roof we've expanded the PV capacity to 50 kilowatts. This meant we also had to increase the inverter capacity with 30 kilowatts of Victron power and 15 kilowatts of a third-party inverter, a Fronius, which was super easy to integrate. For this building, we are now limited to 30 kilowatts of feed-in power.
Well, because the supply line itself simply can't provide any more than it already is. We've reached the absolute limit of the main supply cable.
It's really important that you don't just focus on the electrical system, but also perhaps tell certain end customers what all is possible. 90% of people here in Austria only know that inverters simply feed into the grid and that a backup power system is rather difficult to implement.
Lunchtime right now, you have plenty of power, no one's using it. Everyone's at work, no one's at home.
Now here's the catch. Daniel owns a restaurant just 15 minutes away. But he couldn't just send his extra solar power there. There's no physical cable connecting the two, and legally, you can't just go stringing private power lines across town. Most people would have stopped right there. The dream usually ends where the cables do, but not for Daniel.
We recently won a prize to the best pizzeria in whole Styria, which is quite good for us. And it's powered now with a normal power grid. But the thing is, I can take the power I produce here and sell it or give it even for free to the restaurant.
He didn't need private cables or some massive new infrastructure. All he needed was an app. Suddenly, this small business isn't just an island anymore. It's a power supplier, a mini energy grid operating right in the middle of the community.
eFriends is like a power community where people can produce power with the solar panels or even water and wind and sell it. So right now it's about 30 kilowatt we put back in because of a lovely day, and I can sell it. So when there are people who need power right now and they are connected to my power line, whatever I put up, they can get for the price we negotiate. It's the company which is producing the power. They are using several people to produce more power. And if you have the same provider like eFriends, and then we could connect to each other. There is an app and you can see how much I put up normally or how many kilowatt I put in, how much I charge for it. And then you say, oh, that's attractive for me. I want to connect to him. You just like it and then you can buy from him.
Daniel utilizes Victron Energy's DESS to automatically get the best prices for buying, selling and storing energy.
You have two different modes. You have the green mode and you have the trade mode. And the trade mode is quite interesting if you have a bigger system like I do and a bigger battery storage. For example, every hour the price changes and the system knows that before. So 24 hours, we know the market price. And the system realizes, okay, tomorrow the price at lunchtime is negative. So before I send something into the grid and I have to pay for, I take power out and get paid for. Yeah? So I'm loading the batteries during the lunchtime when the power is almost free. And at night when people needed it, we can resell it for a better price.
This isn't just about making power anymore. It's about playing the market. It's using time, fluctuating prices, and the grid itself as part of the machine. It's software and batteries working together, using Victron's dynamic energy storage system to constantly find the best deal.
So we started with a different kind of batteries. We only had four installed, so we had 20 kilowatt hours. I upgraded it then, so each box has six batteries in there, so there's 30, so by four it's 120, and it looks quite tidy and nice.
Most people see a battery and think storage. Daniel sees a tool to learn, to test and to trade. He's even found ways to have the grid pay him to take extra power off their hands. It's a complete flip of the traditional model.
And in the evening when people are coming home from work at 7, 8 o'clock, there is no light out there, people are using power, they need it. And this is the time where we sell it again. I just need to convince my electrician we need more equipment, and yeah, for that I would definitely like to have two more. So
it's incredible to think this all started just because a father wanted a safe environment for his son. 8 years later, that same system is running a restaurant, supporting local businesses and trading energy across the country. Links to Victron's DESS are in the description below, as well as links to the app Daniel uses.